pure conceit, he takes the crown. He looks in the mirror over and over and claims to have never heard of Pavlova. Nash mentions Pavlova because during the time between Sassoon's death and when Nash wrote the poem, Rachel Caldwell explains in an article from Dance Teacher, in 1905, Russian prima ballerina Anna Pavlova danced the lead in The Dying Swan, set to Sassoon's The Swan, and this became her most famous role. Several of Sassoon's peers did not agree with his post-romanticism. Claude Debussy, the most iconic of the Impressionists, though he didn't consider himself one, was one of these peers. The next piece you'll hear is Debussy's Syrinx for solo flute. This is one of his few theatrical pieces and was originally composed as incidental music to Gabriel Mauret's play, Psyche, and the scene it describes is the interaction between the satyr god Pan and the nymph Syrinx. For the 2011 Baron Reiter edition of Debussy's Syrinx, editor Douglas Woodfull Harris documents Debussy's question to the playwright. Would you please tell me very precisely after what line the music starts? The mythological tale says that in Pan's pursuit of the nymph, as he was known to do, Syrinx transformed herself into reeds